Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today we had an idea about revisiting some of the childhood video games that we had.
Correct.
I don't know how many video games you grew up with. I never hear you talking about them.
Shameful, but like, it's really, really not that much. But I will try my best to bring everything to you guys.
Okay, cool. Now, I had this idea that we'd go through our favorite games, just a few, from age 5 to 10. So I'm going to start out with NES, which is the Nintendo Entertainment System. And I didn't have one as a kid, but I used to play it at my babysitter's, at my friend's house, all these kind of places that were not at my actual house.
Wait, what's that? Are you speaking English?
Nintendo, well actually it's Japanese, but Nintendo, do you know Super Mario Brothers?
Oh yeah, you were spoiled little brat!
Why are you always calling me a spoiled brat? I didn't even have one!
I didn't even see one until I graduated from a primary school!
Whatever. Anyway. The first game I ever played on NES, I was 5 years old. And that would have been in 1990, okay? In 1990, I played Castlevania, and that was actually before I ever played Mario Brothers. So I want you to have a try and see what you think of it.
Oh. I think I probably at that time playing dirt.
Playing with dirt? Okay, good.
Go back.
Just walk over and then hold up at the same time.
Ah!
Ooh, you got hit. This game actually used to scare the hell out of me when I was a kid, which is ridiculous, like looking back on that. You can go through the door.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Ah!
There's a turkey in there. Nice job. Alright, you're gonna die before you get it.
I get it.
Go down the stairs, down, over, left.
Crap, I was scared.
And your dad, I'm so sorry. So Vivi, that was Castlevania. What did you think about that game?
It's very exciting, but I'm so clumsy. Compare with your life, you're ashamed.
Don't feel ashamed. Don't cry. Why are you crying?
Aw,
poor dear. What do you give Castlevania out of 10?
7 out of 10.
Nice.
I really like it, but it's just too clumsy about like jump and shoot. I don't even know what to do.
So Vivi, I'm glad you really liked Castlevania. What do you got for me?
I got the most fantastic, unbelievable in the human kind of game.
Okay, what do we got?
Ready.
Oh, wait a minute. Where did you find one of these? This is one of those water ring toss games.
Look at those, like, you know, background and stuff. How high tech they are.
Dude, these graphics are incredible. Alright, so I gotta get these rings on the... Dude, this is cheap. Literally. This is the worst game ever, but it's like, oh yeah, it's awesome. Oh my gosh. Like clearly this is for little kids, right? Like you wouldn't play this as an adult, but we're looking at our childhood, so I understand.
I don't think so. I bet you love it. I caught you and Prazi playing this after you guys come back from the bar. Guilty as charged. I even record it. Don't try to pretend.
This game, honestly, although it's not a computer game or a video game, as a kid I probably would have been like, I'm not playing that. But like looking back on it, that's actually pretty fun. I'm gonna give this a 5 out of 10 for what it is.
Only 5?
Oh, come on. This...
If you don't have battery, don't have electricity, that's like the best thing you could ever have.
The replayability of this is not that good. Unless you started drinking and like you had to take a shot if you lost a ring or something.
Yeah,
or maybe a time battle.
One day if the earth just run out of water, that can save your life.
True, you take a little sip out of there.
Yes.
Cool. I first played this game in 1992. This is back when Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis were battling each other out, and I was a Super Nintendo fan. Use Z.
Oh.
Don't waste your time. Stop using the other button.
No, I want to eat
that. Use Z. Don't use X.
I can't. Whoa, what the heck is that?
Why would you jump into that?
I don't know, I don't even know what's that!
You got this. Get big.
Nice.
Super Mario World is actually a beautiful game, and I really enjoyed it as a kid. Sonic! Sonic was a game that I used to absolutely love to play with my friends when I went to their house, because although I preferred the Super Nintendo, I was also a big fan of Sonic, the Sonic games. I would go to school and argue that Super Nintendo is better. But... So you played the two classics from my childhood when I was about 8 years old.
Yeah, I love
Mario
it, but
and Sonic.
Really depressing to
Why?
Play. Because I seriously thinking I'm a handicap.
You're not a handicap, you just didn't grow up with this kind of stuff, right?
And
but I have to ask you the time-tested question, the fuel of lunch table debates for years and years. What did you like better, Super Mario World on Super Nintendo, or did you like Sonic better?
I really like the graphic of Sonic.
Must be the blast processing. Anyway, what do you give Mario out of 10?
7.5 out of 10.
Okay, what about the Sonic?
Sonic will be 8. they're up there.
Divorce! So what do you got next for me? I hope it's better than Water Ring Toss.
Trust me, this time is way better. It's digital.
Ooh, digital, an actual video game this time.
Let me try to turn it on. Classic Tetris.
That is the worst sound that has ever come out of anything that I've ever heard. Seriously.
You know what? This one is a precious little diamond. Why? Because this one, you can't even use the regular battery to start it. You need to buy the cheapest.
Okay, so how old are you when you played this game?
8, 9, but I never even own one because my parents were saying like it's bothering my study.
So when I was playing Sonic and Super Mario, you were playing this?
Yes.
Well, this looks great. 99 and 1. Tight graphics, tight control. Oh, and I died. Dude, this is like taking all my attention right now. So there's like 99 games in this.
Yep.
I feel like this is probably the best because they put it on A, and there's like A through Z. This is probably the top game.
You would never feel bored.
I feel like I would feel bored incredibly quickly. That's one of those, like, the dollar store games. How much did you pay for this thing?
3 kwai.
50 cents. So you theoretically bought 99 games for 50 cents. High
yes.
five, that's a great deal.
That worth a lot.
That's awesome. Great job on this one, good find. I give this a 5.5 out of 10. Just because I have more gaming options than the water one. The graphics were worse though. Much worse than the water one. Wow, you had a sad childhood, I'll tell you that. After the 16-bit era of games, we moved on to 3D games, and the first system that I tried was called the PlayStation, the Sony PlayStation. I first tried it in 1995. And the first game I actually really played at my friend's house, I remember, was Tomb Raider 1. But the first game I owned for it was Tomb Raider 2. So that's what I'm going to show you. So I was about 10 years old when this game came out, and it blew my mind. The fact that you didn't walk like sideways on a screen, you were like walking around and like looking around. I remember calling my cousin and saying, dude, there's a game where you like walk around like it's real life. And he was like, what do you mean? Like you could go up and down and left and right? And I was like, no, like everywhere. It just blew our minds.
You know what? Right now, what you're talking to me, it's like alien talk. Because back then, God.
So Tomb Raider 2 takes place in China, actually, and it's called the Dagger of Xi'an. And when I was a kid, I called it the Dagger of Ixian, because I had no idea how to say that. So yeah, there you go, you got jump.
Whoa, actually the graphic is pretty nice.
Yeah, that's a hookup. For 1997, it ain't too bad.
That's water, so should I swim?
Yeah, go ahead. Ooh,
whoa,
what do you see?
Whoa.
Uh-oh, a tiger! She got so excited she closed the screen.
Oh, crap!
You got him!
Really?
Hey, you killed him.
Can I eat anything?
Okay. You gonna eat the tiger? You're so Chinese. So what did you think of Tomb Raider, like the first 3D game that I really got into?
It's amazing. The graphic, if you think about back then, I mean like that will be like somebody's future or something. That will never even come out in my mind for my little brain when back then.
Really?
Yeah.
So that would
course.
Have shocked you. I mean, it
that
shocked will, me to be honest.
That will definitely shock me. And look at the graphic and like actually you can do stuff. stuff. You can shoot stuff and then you can jump and run and looks like a real human being. Oh, I think of one. Mm-hmm. Back then when I finally start to use internet is after when I was in primary school. But before that, I do play one game.
Okay.
So I would love to show you.
You want to load it up for me? All right, Vivi, so this game, I'm actually able to play a PC game that you played in the past. I don't really know what to do because my computer doesn't support the Chinese text function, but I'm assuming from what I gathered, I'm this kid that this woman is like...
Oh, open those closet! Open those closet! Probably something in there. I wonder how can you open... No, there should be some other button.
Yeah, there's one action button, but it's enter and it doesn't do anything. There's nothing in there. So you played this game when you were 10 and you said you like watched your friend's dad play it?
Yeah, and then after that I was just begging her, so like, see, it's summer holiday, can you just like borrow me the disc so that I can...
Yeah. So it was a floppy disc or a CD?
It's a CD, I guess?
It's a CD, nice. High tech.
You can install the... Yeah, it's really expensive too.
Really?
Yeah, only a dog can afford it, and I just like... begging her dad to give it to me.
I'll be honest with you, I was playing Tomb Raider at this time and you're playing this. This is awful. This is like wicked bad. I got something. What's up, dude? Blah, 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 blah. Nice. Vivi, I don't know how much of this I can take.
No,
I feel
really
bad.
No, at the end he's a Kung Fu master and he finds his true love and a lot of girls love him.
Well, you know what? I'm gonna take your word for it. I think you've told me enough. You've told me enough.
Look, I used to think he's so handsome.
If he's handsome, then what the hell are you doing with me? How do you think that makes me feel? So a lot of the games that I showed you, and a lot of the games that you showed me, I had never heard of, you had never played before.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything else that you remember from your childhood, kind of around 10 years old?
I think every single time in the, like the big holiday, for example, Spring Festival or something, my cousin would actually take me to the arcade.
Arcade?
Yeah.
Big memories in the arcade. What games did you play at the arcade?
I think it's called Quan Wang Zhou Ba, which is...
Oh, King of Fighters 98?
Yeah.
I played that as well, so how lucky are we to have played the same game? Guess what? I have a very special surprise.
What?
I happen to have an entire arcade machine right
what
here.
What the?
With 500 games. Actually, Serpent Z.A. Winston built this himself. Inside is 500 arcade games, and including King of Fighters 98. I think we should play against each other.
That looked pretty pikey, but
hey,
yeah.
I think it's awesome. All right, player... First player select, okay.
Why I
or
can't
battling
find
in China.
Myself?
Oh, it's just too late, isn't it?
Hold on. Is it even one player or two player?
Are you playing? Yeah, we're playing.
Okay.
We're playing. All right, I'm on the right. I'm not taking it easy on my wife. Just because you're a girl. Actually, I'm playing as a girl. Are you just button mashing?
Shut up! I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't button mash! It's not fair!
What? There's nothing fair.
I think it is fair. I mean, I don't think it's fair. What am I talking about? Come on!
K.O.
A lot of fun games, that was awesome. Really, really good time, always mm-hmm. playing with you. I am a little bit disappointed in your video game skills, but I'll let it slide.
I don't have that childhood. Like, you guys are so spoiled. We're in a third world country. What else do you expect? Unless you like-
Come on, I can't stand that sound. She's gonna torture me with this thing when I'm sleeping. Seriously, I'm gonna throw this out.
No.
Come on.
No, one day you're begging me to give you this.
Thank you so much, guys. We'll catch you on the next episode.
Like, comment, subscribe. I hope we can see you next time.
High five.
High five.